tell him I dislike the last two last time. So you told that the ladies are 40 years of age. Will you say that menopause average as 47.5 Indian
people? Yeah, you are right.
And at the age of 40, some people may say that these symptoms should not come. But we know that these vasomotor symptoms can come even 6 years before the onset of the menopause. So she is in the right age to get vasomotor symptoms. And since she is quite symptomatic, she needs definitely treatment also.
Yeah.
And for that matter, I divide my treatment into 2-3 parts. First, I would like to know the in history of this patient details. Number one, whether she is menopause or she is still having menstrual cycle. Or is it pre-menopausal state and having irregular menstrual cycle? Or she has already attained menopause, which sometimes you say pre-onset of menopause, like or surgical menopause. So I have to take the history whether the uterus is intact or she is the patient has got hysterectomy done, because my treatment will differ in these two situations. Patient who has got intact uterus, and if I am jumping on to HRT treatment, I should put the patient on estrogen as well as progesterone. But if the patient is already having surgical menopause, like hysterectomy has been done, the patient can manage only estrogen. That is very important for to know about the uterus status while treating vasomotor symptoms. Second thing, I will not jump directly to HRTs. I like to see other background of the patient, just say told whether she is naturally sensitive nature, other things, then I will manage with her with tranquilizer, other thing. For that matter, third part is the phytoestrogens. Phytoestrogens is a natural gift of estrogen from the sources of plant sources. And they are also quite useful in mending. And we have got source of phytoestrogens like soya beans and this tail bhoga you take in winters. And then alsi, these things are very rich in phytoestrogen, and we have found that they really help in the vasomotor symptom. Once I have made my plan to put the patient on HRT treatment, I will have a gynecologist opinion also, like pelvic examination, breast examination, and then further tests like routine investigation, CBC, blood sugar, lipid profile. All these things should be done before putting the patient on treatment.
Dr.
Initially, before I start off with my answer, I'd like to thank Dr. Parminder Singh. It's been an honor, sir, to be your student during DMC days, and to be here in front of you today presenting is really an honor. Coming to menopausal symptoms, well, the coronary artery disease relation to menopause has been studied extensively. There have been numerous studies which initially showed that as women approach menopause or when there's a decrease in estrogen levels, which is the main outcome that is the cause of menopause, the falling estrogen also leads to an increase in cardiovascular risk. That is because estrogen is protective in cardiovascular diseases. They are lipid, they lower the lipids, they bring down the LDL, which is the main culprit in coronary artery disease. And they also increase the HDL levels. Then the most important thing about estrogens is that they bring about endothelial stabilization. They reduce the endothelial dysfunction in patients, in women. That is why they say that younger women are protected when they have not yet approached menopause. Now, is menopause or these hot flushes the symptoms of menopause risk factor for coronary artery disease? Initially, it was thought, yes, the decline in estrogen does lead to increasing coronary artery disease incidence, but numerous other studies and when multiple variables were studied, as these ladies generally are approaching 45-50, this is also the age when men start getting increase in their coronary artery disease. So when all these other variables, when they were put together in few of the larger studies or larger trials or larger randomized trials, what they found was that no, these variables, especially the hot, the symptoms and the falling estrogen level, do not correlate with the increased risk of coronary.
Okay, Dr. Jindu Mazar, I think we'll come back again to coronary because I have some other slides. So basically, you see, there are some studies that have shown that we, especially the heart flushes of the night sweats, they are associated with increased incidence of CHD. So we'll be coming out that one thing which you have pointed out that in the younger women, rather estrogen is protective, but perhaps later on when the disease process such is not that effective. Now, we patient is having hot flushes and they are related with any are they related to mood disorders, depression and sleep disorders?
Yes, thank you for inviting me to your panel and thank you Dr. Mandel for spreading this to you from UC and then. See, hot flushes usually arise with the onset of menopause. And menopause has very negative connotations as such. There is negative anticipation associated with menopause. And once the female starts realizing that she is going to have menopause, so the incidence of psychiatric disorders also tend to increase. We see that a patient who is already having major depressive disorder, she might relapse or the symptoms worsen. A patient of having schizophrenia usually tends to have worsening of symptoms. Similarly, patient having bipolar disorder or panic attacks would usually have worsening of symptoms after menopause. So every time a patient comes to us in follow-up, we usually ask, are you having a face regularly? Is there any difficulty? So if she is experiencing any of these symptoms, we might need to do a rethink that she is going through that.
So basic fact is that hot flushes do interfere with the quality of life issues of the women. And might be some psychiatric problems later on. We'll be discussing those problems later on in details. So they can disrupt the family life, they can cause the depression and everything, and we'll be coming to that later on with the presentation. So treatment of heart patients, we have already mentioned, we have to give effort. Now can you highlight how this effort has to be given, how they have to select the patient? Are there some alternative therapies also which has to be given?
As far as the heart flushes are concerned, first thing is it's a lifestyle modification which we have to see, and we have to see that patient's age, whether she is 35, 40, or the privilege of menopause, surgical menopause, and of course, is the patient hypertensive, obese, any coronary disease, and any other things, or she on any medicines also. So as far as HRT is concerned, as soon as the patient attains menopause, the best time, the window period, is the first 5 years of her life. So we have to introduce HRT because we have certain long-term effects, that is cardiovascular, osteoporosis. So they can be prevented in case we can start the HRT very time, as soon as the patient, rather than both days. The epigenium in the beginning is very responsive. So HRT should be started early in the case patient has heart flushes, and if we are thinking that she can have long-term problems with osteoporosis and cardiovascular disease.
Are there any alternative therapies for the horse flesh?
Yes, phytoestrogens and of course many things which Chinese they confirm, aquaculture.
What are the roles of gabapentin, venlafaxine, doxorubicin? Can you highlight on them?
Because we know that there are certain diseases, neurotransmitters, and they affect the mood and as well as the vasomotor symptoms. And we got the various neurotransmitters like serotonin, norepinephrine, dopamine. And by modulating them or playing these molecules with drugs, we can improve certain symptoms. We know that in the nervous system, one cell talks to the another cell. And this is through the neurotransmission. And once these neurotransmitters like serotonin, let us say if it is lowered, then the symptoms of depression, anxiety, hot flush, they will come. And by giving drugs like SSRIs or SNRIs, we increase the level of the neurotransmitters and they will help us to reduce the symptoms related to the vasomotor problems. And venlafaxine has been tried well and has been found useful for maintaining symptoms. Other drugs like citalopram is very good, 20 milligrams to 20 milligrams citalopram is also quite effective. Here I would like to mention that rather I ask you the panelists, what I have learned is that Indian women are less prone to have vasomotor symptoms compared to the Western population, Japanese, Chinese and Indian. And the cause has been because of the increased increase the phytoestrogen in our diet. They say that in Japan the average intake of phytoestrogen around 50 mg per day, and in other Asians it is 25 to 45 mg per day, and in Western population it is only less than 5 mg per day. And I think that corroborates the finding that Indian population or Chinese or this population, they have got less incidence of vasomotor symptoms. Similarly, phytoestrogen help in, not to this point, of phytoestrogen help in reducing the osteoporosis also. And the population in China and Japan, they are taking less milk and milk products, but they are taking more soya products. And the incidence of osteoporosis is much less in them compared to Indian population. But I want to stress that phytoestrogens have got definite role, and they really help in reducing the vasomotor symptoms, which we already have less compared to the rest of the population.
That's okay, Dr. Sikha, you are right. And about the Japanese, it's not just the phytoestrogens, it might be some other substances also. Because in the morning itself, yesterday, I was listening to a news where they said that they have about in thousands persons who are living beyond the age of 100 years in Japan. So I think they have a good diet and a lifestyle modification, and perhaps their system of that prayers and all that which is helping a lot. So that's why it has to be a holistic approach towards the problems of the women along with. Now this is a very case important thing which all of us are dealing. That is the 46 years of Radha comes with some vague aches and pains and fever, and we treat her symptomatically and we send her back. So that is what happened with all of us. We did that. Even as a gynecologist, we did that. Now what happened then later on? The same woman, she came back to us at the age of 68 years. She fell down in the bathroom. She had a hip fracture. She had a severe heart attack and was to be suffering from cervical cancer. So what all of us were doing? A missed opportunity. So that was the only opportunity all of us get through counsel that women. And if we don't counsel, they are not going to come to us again. They might come up with one of these symptoms only. So that means as a physician, our role has been absolutely negative.
So as far as people is concerned, any physician is going to test up all the fever. But that is an opportunity. As you said, we must have a questionnaire from head to toe. We ask each and every person, this is the time to counsel her. Okay, we are treating your fever, but you are coming back for your metabolic checkup and we do everything for you late on. For that, you know, self-breast examination, the pap smear, we can just counsel them at that time. So that really after her fever is treated, then we are going to do all the serum, calcium, maybe vitamin D or bone density and whatever it is. So that is the time we are telling her everything about the menopause, guiding and teaching her and calling her back again.
So that is the telling home message that the patient won't listen to us at all at that time because they want the symptomatic treatment only. But get them registered in your clinic for any 35 plus, have their no phone number, tell them that you are going to have some problems and we'll be getting in touch with you. Or you come back, just call her back, get her lipid file tomorrow. And when she comes for her lipid file, tell her that she needs her blood sugar also. When she gets it done, tell her that she needs mammography or you should be doing breast self-examination and all that. So that we don't miss opportunities. I am glad having so many young doctors in my panel because you are the future torch bearers for the health of midlife women. And I am thankful to Dr. Sushma and Dr. Sujit for giving me this an opportunity.
So actually it's very good because that time yes, they are not able to listen to us. If they got younger members with them, so that is the time to hand over some template about the menopause of things so that they can go and read it and come back again. So I think if the doctor is better to teach the doctor, if some is coming, it's better to teach the doctor.
Yes. Amina Degamma, she is 46 years old and she is having irregular periods. Dr. Kamal, you have to answer. She has skipped now for 2 months. What do we do?
For 46-year-old female, she has skipped her period for 2 months. We may not consider it as menopause, but we should take this opportunity to examine her thoroughly. We should do a local examination, her ultrasound scan, her pap smear, her mammography. We should teach her self-examination of the breast. We should subject her to all the medical tests to rule out any lipid profile as we were already talking, her urea creatinine, her blood pressure level, and her any tendency to develop any medical illness.
Yeah, that's good. But she can be pregnant also. That she is having all those problems.
We have done scan also.
Why don't you do UPD for the first time the patient comes to you with the missed periods? Don't forget about that thing. Because she might be having and you are absolutely right about other things, absolutely right. The only thing is that the patients are having their irregular periods, that does not mean that they cannot conceive during that period. That is a very important kind of message which I want to give out, that the patients can get pregnant. So you are thinking, she's having menopause, she's 48 years old. Why she thought that she should have? I have menopause, why she's having? Now she's not having her periods. And she might be, she's already pregnant 6 months, but she doesn't know. So don't try to forget about the pregnancy also in this period, about this time when she's having lots of irregular periods. Now, who is the urologist? Dr. Swapan. Yeah, Swapan. Now, sir, now it's the time for you to get up. Sometimes you get the patients